Hey people, welcome back to another episode of Cooler Playing XCOM Enemy Unknown. Today's episode is episode 23. We're gonna investigate this crashed UFO site. Let's do it.
Let's do it, boys, yeah!
So this time I'm gonna be bringing a droid with me. Lightning One. Mainly because I'm not it, you know? I'm just like not there. With the whole training soldiers. Engineering, build items. Sniper is wounded. All right. I'm gonna have to make do with these three people.
Touching down. Listen up. We're going to be dropping you deep in the Nigerian interior for the next operation. It looks like the aliens went down in a sparsely populated area. If there are civilians in the area, I hope they stay clear.
Hostile targets at the crash site.
Alright, so this is a new ship, a different ship. So this ship might contain one of two new aliens, either a sectopod, which is the worst enemy to fight, or the next evolution to the Muton, which is a Muton guard. Cyber disc and some crystals.
This looks to be a supply ship of some kind, and the potential storage capacity is enormous. If the aliens are really attempting to bring in this much outside material, it can only mean they're ramping up the scale of the invasion.
All shit.
Moving to firing position.
Moving to the speed of death. So our first newcomers, visitors, are the cyber disc and drone.
That's a load of bull. Hostile spotted. Missed the target.
I gotta stop moving my dudes. I can't throw a grenade in there, so I'm gonna suppress fire.
Keeping him down. I'm all out.
Thank you. Wow, he went down with one shot. Shot as well.
It's killing time.
He's gonna shoot at that guy.
Watch the place.
Looks like. Thanks, man. Guys are pretty much using light pistols, plasma pistols. Is on an operation. He has a real weapon, online. Which is gonna take a turn. So I'm gonna have to use my bot.
anything?
Hey, you know, when an unknown number calls you, it's always funny when you answer the phone with a different language. You say, like, hello in a different language to them, because, like, then they don't know how to, like, react to that. I'm gonna pull this guy back. I have one of two choices here. I could either suppress fire all three of these, or launch a rocket, which is going to do 8 damage, but it's going to destroy a lot of stuff. And over here, I could potentially launch a rocket, but actually I'm going to throw a grenade at this guy. I can't really move him. We need to move this person into cover and then suppress fire. This guy needs to get healed. Damn it.
Shot wide.
Oh my god, no! Man, that's my grenadier, man.
I'm alright!
Killing time.
You'll be back in the fight ASAP.
Yo, man, using the Mind Fray ability in XCOM 2 worked very differently than in this one here. You're like almost always going to hit the target with it, but in this, there's a low percentage. I'm gonna capture this guy.
Light him up. Tell the doc we're bringing home
Commander,
a live one.
The operation was a success.
No, it was not, Central. It was not a success. Somebody died. Killer Instinct. Activating Running Gun allows. Also grants plus 50% critical damage for the rest of the game. Killed in action. He had like 18 kills and 10 missions, bro. But this guy, this chick has 20 missions and 30 kills. Rest in peace, man. Practically the same animation as the Recon.
This unit appears to be a drone, which is similar to the military drones we are familiar with. This particular example seems to have the ability to repair damaged equipment. Dr. Shen and I believe it should be possible to capture and repurpose these for our own use in the field.
Foundry project available, drone capture. We're confident that our arc throwers could be upgraded to allow the capture enemy drones, giving us control of the flying drones for the remainder of the combat. Oh, this is pretty much like hacking them. So, is it like you put an arc thrower on them and then they change sides? They do that? What?
Commander, our satellite is prepped and standing by for launch. We are ready to deploy.
Nobody
on your
is
orders.
Gifted. Fiddlesticks. Okay, I still have Jeremy West and our heavy over here. So let me go to these soldiers, Jeremy West, and then remove this armor, this weapon. Hopefully Jeremy West will be the next candidate. This is pretty much like Shadow Chamber in XCOM 2. You're able to see which units are on the mission.
To the aliens, our engineering team has managed to negate billions of dollars in traditional aerospace development with a single ship.
Alright, so United States is practically screwed. Satellite Nexus gives me 5 more satellites to use. Let's put one in. I could put one in Asia.
Satellite launched. Satellite launched.
Let me build some more satellites.
The new engineers arrived this morning, Commander. We're always glad to have more help down here.
Plasma cannon. Oh, they're already built? Okay. Let's go to hangar. New shipless. Let's go to Demon 1. Let's edit loadout. Let's change it to this. It's gonna be a 1 day. Alright, so the tier 3 weapons, the shotgun, the tier 3 shotgun works very looks very differently than the tier 3 assault rifle.
Now that we are in control of the hyperwave beacon, the real question is, what is it going to tell us? Perhaps we should try scanning for UFO activity in the meantime.
Commander, we have multiple reports of new abductions in progress. The locations are marked on the hologlobe.
We're going to be going for Vancouver, Canada. Get them 4 engineers in. You feel me, fam?